Hello?
Hey, Jack, can you hear me?
Yes, I can. What's up, Ty?
Hey, so I have a really good idea for a collab.
Yeah, what you thinking?
So, have you seen the show Stranger Things?
Dude, don't even get me started on that show. I've seen it like 7 times over, so you can bet. I've seen the show.
Oh, dude, that's perfect, because I was thinking we should do a collab based off of the show. So, I was thinking we can make like the inside of the Byers House.
The inside? Like just the inside?
Yeah.
Okay, when do you want to get this out?
So what do you think?
Yeah, I'm down to do it, I don't know. Okay, well, who knows when we'll get it out, but I'll get to work. It sounds fun.
Well, come on and let me know.
Hey, what's going on, guys? It is Jack here, and today I am extremely excited to show you another Stranger Things mock. This is the third installment in building Stranger Things, so if you haven't seen any of the previous Stranger Bricks episodes, I will leave them linked down below so you can give those a watch, but I'm very happy to introduce TD Bricks. If you don't know who he is, he's a very popular LEGO YouTuber, and he's going to be joining me on my endeavor in building Stranger Things. For our first collaboration, we decided we would recreate the inside of the Byers household. The LEGO set did not do it justice, so we took it upon ourselves to recreate almost an exact replica of the inside while taking your own creative liberties and making the necessary adjustments to make it fit. For Ty's mock, he decided to go with an almost exact replica of the floor plan for this house, but I decided I would fit this all on a 32 by 32 base plate, so I did a little bit of rearranging. I sacrificed the dining room, which you rarely see in the show, and moved Joyce's bedroom a little bit so everything would fit, but everything inside the rooms is actually oriented perfectly, so it looks very accurate in itself. For a basic overview of the house, you can see there's the main entrance up along the front. On the left-hand side of that is the living room, on the right-hand side is the kitchen, and then there's a hallway directly in front of the doorway. There's a bathroom and Jonathan's bedroom on the right-hand side, and Joyce's and Will's bedroom on the left. I guess it would make most sense to start in the living room because that is a very important room, at least in season one. As you can see, it has all the necessary details to make it look very accurate, going from the letters on the walls to the lights on the ceiling and the trash and the couch and the bookshelf. This room was actually one of the easiest to recreate because there was a lot of reference material for this. I actually recreated the wallpaper, that is very ugly by the way, by using a bunch of sand green plates and white bricks. It makes that kind of green and white pattern that you see in the show. I also used a bunch of 1x1 plates and circular tiles and a bunch of random pieces to recreate the letters on the walls. I don't actually have anything to make it look like letters, so I went with that, and you can kind of tell what it's going for. But it certainly matches the ugliness of the rest of the room. She has a very disgusting looking couch with the yellow and the white stripes. I guess it's just okay because they look like they're a low income family in the 1980s, so it's perfectly acceptable. But there's a lot of junk thrown across the room, such as in the far right hand corner, right next to the couch, but there is a bookshelf that looks pretty cool along the far wall, and a chair that kind of sits opposite to the couch. Making the Christmas lights that actually hang over this room was very tough. I don't have the right pieces to make it look natural. In the LEGO set, they use a couple of rope pieces that are in black, but I don't have those in that color. I only have them in white because of the Spider-Man sets, so I used some pieces from the IREX set that are actually bendable, and I attached some clips on there and some studs, and I think it looks sufficient enough. I actually kind of like the way it bends a little bit more than the ropes. Next to that is a nice change of pace. The kitchen is a whole lot cleaner than the living room, probably because she doesn't spend as much time there messing up the walls and doing a lot of crazy stuff she does in season 1 and 2, but there's a pretty cool round table and some chairs going along in the middle. I used a pretty cool technique to make that table. From what I could tell from the actual show, it looks like the cabinets were a dirty white, so I used some white jumper plates to create the drawers, and some dark tan tiles and jumper plates to create the counter. I think it looks pretty accurate, but it's kind of hard to see in there. Moving down the hallway, the first first door will actually take you into the bathroom, and a lot of stuff happens here, especially in Season 2 and towards the end of Season 1. I won't spoil anything, but when you walk in, you can see there is the sink that's actually very disgusting in the show, hanging out of the wall. That's a very illegal technique, but it's really cool, and I like the way that thing plays out. In the far corner is the very small toilet. I tried to make things as small as possible in here because I was running out of space. On the opposite side is the bathtub, which I actually think turned out pretty well, especially the shower head, which also is very illegal. This is probably not the best bathroom, but I think it looks pretty cool. Moving down the hallway along the same side is my favorite bedroom in the entire house. This is Jonathan's. I think it's probably the best because of the bed. I think that's the selling point. It looks very messy, and I like the way that thing looks unmade. Opposite to that is a pretty cool bookshelf technique. It's using some window frames to create that effect. It's using that same technique out in the living room, but I really like the way that thing looks. There's a cardboard box in the corner and a bunch of furniture right in front of the window. And I also made sure to include the boombox that plays Should I Stay or Should I Go in the beginning of Season 1. And kind of throughout it, because it's kind of important if you watch the show. And the final thing in this room is a tile to represent that pretty cool poster that Lonnie tells Jonathan to take down, if you catch my drift. Across from his room is Will's bedroom, and there's a lot of detail in here. I made sure to include the bed that's made with the blue covers and a bunch of lamps going around, because this is where Joyce kind of goes insane, at least that's what everybody thinks. I put an Easter egg in here that doesn't make sense for this time frame, but it hints at the start of Season 2 with the Ghostbusters cage directly next to the bed. And then the final room in this house is one where I got to take all kinds of creative liberty, because there's absolutely no reference in the show whatsoever. This is Joyce's bedroom. She doesn't spend any time in here, at least in Season 1. So I just put a bed, a simple dresser, a simple bookshelf, and a bunch of junk thrown about the room just to match the theme of the rest of the house. And to wrap this thing up, I included some pretty bad minifigures. I'm not great at building minifigures. First of all, I don't have the parts, and second of all, I'm just not good at them, so I included a pretty bad Steve. There's a very ugly Jonathan, and I guess the best minifigure, Nancy. She's the most accurate just because she looks like a traditional girl. But that will cover this entire mock. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like down below. Give some more suggestions for some Stranger Things mocks. If you haven't seen any of the other ones, I will leave them linked down below. Follow me on Instagram for some more updates. But as always, thanks so much for watching, and most importantly, take care, guys.